Hello, and so today we're with Nicholas Lim, who is the Director of Sales and Marketing Asia for Contiki Holidays for 18 to 35s. Good afternoon, Nicholas.
Thank you, Steve. Hi.
Now, please, before we begin, just tell us a little bit about Contiki Holidays. What is it? What is it all about, and how long have you been doing it?
We're an escorted touring company for 18 to 35-year-olds. We've been around since 1962, well over 40-something years. And we are continuing to do what we have done at the very inception of our company's start, and we are now doing tours for to Europe, Australia, New Zealand, and now even in Indochina. So it's a very sociable kind of experience where young people from all over the world, they come together and they have a lot of fun. They see the dream destinations. They socialize with other 18 to 35s who are also from around the world. So you get the Aussies, the Kiwis, Singaporeans, Japanese, Koreans, everybody will come together and then they will see the whole world together. Brilliant. Yes.
Sounds very interesting. Now, with Contiki, there are different components to your business. There's the bus aspect, there's the adventure travel aspect. Yep. I'd like to focus today a little bit on the adventure travel aspect of the business.
Sure.
In terms of the adventure travel business, how much is that part of the Contiki experience? How much does it make up of the business?
Well, it all really depends on what is classified as adventure. I mean, for anyone who's living home for the very first time, going to Europe, which is a huge place, to see London, Paris, Rome, and that itself is an adventure, you know. So you have things, but and we do adventures to all over the world, but within these countries we do also the white knuckle stuff. We do the soft adventures, things like, for example, in Austria you can do a white water rafting. In let's say in Queenstown in New Zealand, of course, you can do your bungee jumps, you can do your shot over jets and stuff like that. You can jump on aeroplanes if you want. But if you want to just take things easy, chill out, you can just also do a horseback riding up the nice little mountains. And we have tours or optionals that would cater to different aspects depending on your appetite for such adventures. Yes.
How has this market evolved in the last 40 odd years that the Contiki's been around? How has it grown? Is it a growing aspect of your business?
Oh, you bet. I think definitely it has grown. I think it's tremendous. Even the downtime, for example, last year, numbers still maintained. It hasn't dropped, and this year numbers have just gone through the roof. Really, people are coming back. The 18 to 35s are, I would say, a market that's fairly resilient to what's happening in the economy. Yeah, and then they are still buying tours, they're going for their nice adventures, going to see Paris, you know, and have their time of their life. Yeah.
Now, as you mentioned, it is very much focused on the 1835 at the moment.
Yes.
However, even your company, yourself, I believe as well, don't even qualify in terms of that age group.
Just.
Does Contiki have any plans to possibly do 36 to 46 or some other age group, or is it just going to concentrate on the 18 to 35 market?
Well, not at all. We have discussed this many times at our board meetings and our meetings, but we still remain true to our business and through the 18 to 35 bracket, because through this then we are able to still deliver the kind of experience that 18 to 35s are looking out for. So we're not going to do the 30 somethings, 40 somethings. No, 18 to 35, it is what it is, and because of this range we are able to streamline, we're able to do a better job at delivering the whole 18 to 35 experience. Yeah, I mean, for example, on our coaches, we on tours, you get a tour manager is also 18 to 35. We do, and then we have like music, we have music like from the Black Eyed Peas and things like that. So we are able, these bits and pieces, we put it all together for the 18 to 35 experience, so we're not going to dilute that at all.
Right. Now, another growing segment in the in the travel industry is for women travellers, independent women travellers.
Yes.
Do you have any plans to offer any women tours, women only tours?
We don't have any plans, but if a travel agent comes to us, one of our retailers comes to us, and if they want to do an all-girl trip, we are able to do so. But having said that, I mean, on all our tours, we're well equipped to have independent single ladies join us on our tours. For example, we get a lot of single Japanese and Korean girls traveling by themselves in Europe on a Contiki tour for 21 days, for example. So they do things all on their own, and they have fun with other people from around the from different parts of the world as well. So they get to learn people's culture. People learn their culture. There's a lot of mixing and matching and things like that. So they have a lot of fun. They get a lot of out of these trips. Yeah.
Now you are in charge of the Asia Pacific market.
Yes.
Where do most of the customers from this region go to? Where are the primary destinations
Europe.
The most popular?
Europe. Europe is still our primary destination.
And within Europe?
Europe, you have things like London, Paris, Rome. You know that because we get a lot of clients who are first timers. Haven't been out of their country sometimes. I mean, they've been around the region, but hasn't done that big trip. So usually they would want to see London, Paris, Rome, Switzerland. So we have a lot of that. But we also see a growing trend of young couples and honeymooners going to Greece. And we have many tours and many itineraries that run around Greece. We have 13 days Greek island hopping. They stay on the islands. Yeah, and they can do whatever that they want to do, you know. So we have a whole buffet of tours that they can select from. Yep.
Now, why 18 to 35? These people are very independent.
Yes.
They want to do this. They want to do that. They might change their minds midway.
Yes.
Why would they work with Contiki? Why not just do it themselves?
Well, if they are all very savvy travelers and they have done their homework, they will find that going on a Contiki will save them easily 25% to 45% on the same that they are going to do anyway. So with a Contiki, they're able to get all this hassle all done. We handle everything, point-to-point transportation, door-to-door, accommodations there, tour manager is there to assist, and then they're there to enjoy, to have a good time. That's what they pay money for, and that's their investment of their time. They're there to enjoy and not get lost, not pay extras for this, not get ripped off, etc., etc. Yeah.
With the economic crisis that we're experiencing, or just coming out of, some people say, has there been a shift away from Europe into the interregional, maybe the Australasian, New Zealand markets?
No, none at all. Yeah, none at all. We do see very slight shift from the hotel product to a more to our concept budget product, but it's still kept within that range. So we haven't lost a lot of numbers, no. It's just people are just trading down. They are trading down instead of staying at a hotel, and now they're buying a Contiki budget tour. Yeah.
Oh, interesting. We were just coming back to the adventure travel side of things.
Yes.
We mentioned there, obviously, people will automatically think of New Zealand. They'll automatically think of Cape Town in South Africa.
Yep.
In terms of the adventure travel segment of the tours that you do, in this region,
yep,
what is there that you offer in terms of adventure travel within Asia Pacific?
Within Asia Pacific, in things like we have our tours to our trips to NZ. Of course, we do things like the bungee jumps, you do the shot over jets, you know, we have real white knuckled stuff like that. In Australia, you can do your tandem skydive, you can learn to surf, and which is all included. For example, we have a package that takes you on a surf school, and it's all included, yeah. And then these are or if you want to just do a bike ride around Vietnam, we have that as well. So it's all it's all catered for. It all depends on your appetite for adventure. I mean, you want the hardcore stuff, or you want something that's a bit more slower pace.
Is there anything in this region, Vietnam or China, or anything particular that stands out within this region?
We have just started our Vietnam, our tours around Indochina, and that's really, really picking up very, very well. So we get a lot of bookings from Australia and New Zealand into Vietnam, and they're having a great time because it's the first time probably in Asia, and they say, wow, you know, don't know what to expect. So it's and they go in and they have fun, and they talk with the locals, and they see, wow, and say, this is Asia, this is really, really Asia, and they get to stay in sometimes with the village, and then they are pretty happy with the whole experience.
So this is Vietnam, which you just launched recently.
Indochina,
which covers Cambodia and a few other countries.
Laos, Cambodia, and Vietnam.
Excellent, excellent. And who most of these customers, they're coming from Australia, or are they also Asian customers as well?
We do get the bulk of it from Australia, from North America. We get some Kiwis as well, some South Africans. Asia, we're starting to see the numbers pick up a little bit. Yep, and so they are, because they say, oh, this is something new. 10 days Vietnam, they want to do in Ho Chi Minh out Hanoi. So they want to do the whole Vietnam experience. Yep.